when the shit would never be in there. Anyway, this authorizes police to obtain a genetic sample from every person arrested on felony charges, not just those convicted. Some 25 other states have enacted similar laws since 62% of California electorate passed the measure in 2004. This shit's 6 years old and they're still fucking doing it. Now they want to make it all the way around because profiling doesn't make sense anymore. We figured out what the definition was, okay? The issue of the warrantless swabbing of the cheek with a Q-tip of everyone arrested for a felony has sparked one of the hottest search and seizure debates in the state and federal courts in decades. It's real simple on a what the fuck there, baby, okay? Let me remind you that your Fourth Amendment rights are fucking on the chopping block. These shits are at stake. Unless the majority of the voting public votes it away, then try not to do the same shit we do every year out of fucking fear.
Everything is good, too much of any good thing is bad. Everything is good, too much of any good thing is bad. Everything is good, too much of any good thing is bad. Everything is good. Everything is good. Everything is good. I'm good, you good, we good, what's good? Who am I trying to convince? Would I even believe myself if I could? If it was really good, I probably wouldn't be saying none, which literally means I'd still probably be saying some. Or is it pronounced probably? Probably. I'm so bad with words. I just mean to say that I'm not as good as I feel I should. There's a hole within my soul and it didn't come from inside of me. I feel that it was placed there purposely, but the purpose is eluding me. And I can clearly see that the means to the end ain't really the end to the means, and the means equal more, and the more has become obscene. Painted by pornographers, liars, and thieves alike who put their claws into everything. I hope they don't cut my mic, so I'm like, everything is good. Everything is good. The ships are still afloat and the sky is not falling yet. And my mic's still on, so I guess it must be okay to vent. But if my venting revealed the purpose, they'd probably get upset. So I'm like, everything is good. Everything is good. Hands raised clearly so they don't pepper spray me for talking. Can someone please tell me who let all these suits walk in? Disguised in riot gear, rocking rubber bullets to boot. They say it's a more humane way to deal with protesters and groups. I wonder what it would take for the seriousness to take hold. I bet it would feel more real once they've taken over your home, dictated what you reap, how and when exactly to sow. It's not a him or they, it's us who let all this unfold. And it's protected fiercely, so I joke when I get too bold, and I'm like, everything is good. Everything is good. I feel like I gotta whisper this last part, listen close. All the pieces to the puzzle are in you. First shed your fears, only then should you continue. The answers are not found in the means, if only in pieces. I hope that you can find your peace. When you do link up, please remember, everything is good. Too much of any good thing is bad. Everything is good. Too much of any good thing is bad. Everything is good. Too much of any good thing is bad. But everything is good. Everything is good.
Shit, they look it again. They look it again. Check up underneath the cupboards, motherfuckers. That's where you're not seeing me. Dirty condoms. Ah, yes, tis the season to be towing again. So make sure your cars are insured because the city is looking for extra cash and your angst in court. This for the next 51 days before the primary elections start. Okay? For real, they just pulled three cars off my block this morning. Let's see, whole report is stable. No new chunk bucks in the meat choking clothing department, which means no new prison slobs for another 30 days until the raids are on again. And yep, the curb servers are gone. That's right. Thanks to the ass-busting efforts of yours truly, I still didn't get the reward, but the evidence I left with the police department was well prepared. That's right, well, you fucking right. You know, if I'm getting some money out of it, I'm snitching your broke ass out. Fuck you, okay? Guess that means that I can now sleep peacefully, you know, past 4 hours without hearing a hoe running down the street in 99 cent store shoes talking about give me my money at 3 o'clock in the morning.
Naggers, Jews, homosexuals, Mexicans, Arabs, and all kinds of different chanks. Stay! Where would I start? Well, first of all, they're lazy, good-for-nothing tricksters, crack-smoking swindlers, big butt-having, wide nose, breathing all the white man's air. They eat up all the chickens. They think they're the best dancers. And they stink. Did I mention that before?
Yes, I believe you did, sir.
naggers, Jews, homosexuals, Mexicans, Arabs, and all kinds of different chanks. Stank!
He was the only Negro we'd ever had around here. He was the only Negro we'd ever had around here. So we figured we'd make it easier on Clayton by just telling him and all the other blind kids that he was white.
Oh, yes, you know what time it is. It's time for cultural nepotism, all right? Okay, my mensos out there, okay? If La Migra ain't all up in your ass, then why are you fucking yourselves into Jim Crow policies that make it as much sense as bathing in sulfuric acid? Okay, here's another sting from the corporate headquarters of Mi Pueblo Food. Check it. With 21 grocery chains throughout the Bay Area, Monterey Bay, and Central Valley, bounded by now legal Junivar Chavez. I mean, he brings the character of the name down with his shit. Okay, is voluntarily participating in a federal program that checks the immigration status of all new workers. Company officials said that although they were critical of E-Verify, they felt, quote unquote, tremendous pressure from the immigration officials to sign up. Community organizers have pledged to launch a shoppers boycott on October 8th. And let's see, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That should be on a Monday. Bad Monday if Mi Pueblo's founder doesn't change his mind. Okay, here we go. What the fuck? Okay? Since when do terror cults become the norm? Oh, that's right. Mike Broman at Beachbody is. So there you have it. Talk about traditional family values here. Okay, the controversy has highlighted long-standing questions about how immigration and customs enforcement, an arm of the Homeland Department of Security, which decides which business to audit, and how aggressively agents are pushing the computerized E-Verify program behind the scenes. According to ICE, okay, and that's the fucking gang-busting unit, there have been 3,764 workplace probes in the fiscal year 2012 so far, more than double the number in 2009. In the last year, ICE has fined employers nearly $20 million. 133 company managers were convicted of immigration-related crimes. Okay, what the fuck twice? This shit smells of Arizona all fucking day as immigrant rights activists have complained that ICE has been transparent, about how it selects its investigative targets and negotiates out-of-sight deals, side deals with them. Critics also contend that the probes hurt businesses that depend on low-wage immigrant labor, forcing them to scrap your entire workforces. But here's the tickler. None of the white-owned businesses that have complied, and as sure as shit, the racism is at a federal level when border crossings have gone down recently. This is what a military pincer maneuver looks like. Cut off the supply and make race traders out of your own people. That's not revolutionary. That's called making decision within the ranks possible so that everyone who is illegal can't vote or make issues of immigration policy suitable. When you factor in criminal fining, you only push the rat into a corner that's dangerous. Get the boycott happening and make Juanaval or Junaval Chavez see the error of his ways, because if they can do it to you, damn it, what's not to stop them from doing it to others who are legally here, still running from Veracruz? Real simple. And yes, we've gotten to that part, ladies and gentlemen. Our butt end of the show, as we like to call it. But yet alone, we do our you know, namaste exercises here to clear the air from down there. So, do this with me one time. One, and a two, and on three, asshole of the day. Coughing up a donut in a hairball. Okay, there's an old saying that goes, if people are followers, then they'll come to a consensus to follow the rules of the leader in which they think have their best interests. Like many a model of corporations that exploit and cover up things that would otherwise be social embarrassment to the organization, I find that the sheriff's department is no exception to the rule when the watchdogs have gotten a good chunk of that authoritarian ass and refuse to let go. Check it. A damning presentation by investigators to a county commission examining jail violence depicted Baca as a disengaged and uninformed manager who failed to prevent abuses of inmates in jail by jail deputies. The jail scandal erupted last year when the FBI was secretly investigating allegations of abusive deputies in the lockups. As a part of the probe, agents paid a corrupt deputy to smuggle a cell phone to an inmate informant. Baca was initially defiant and critical of the federal probe, but the misconduct continued to mount. Jailers were busted for bringing in drugs to jail. Internal memos showed department brass raised alarms about excessive force and deputies inflicting quote-unquote jailhouse justice on inmates. Some deputies came forward with tales of beatings and cover-ups. Okay, you know where I'm going with this. What the fuck? Okay, this is where quote-unquote pass the buck is so rampant out in the LA. Undersheriff Paul Tanaka is accused by the commission investigators of urging deputies to be aggressive and discouraging investigations of misconduct that would include brutalizing prisoners and harassing minority residents of the Antelope Valley. So guess who's following whose orders to do what? If Baca doesn't embrace the commission's advice, then Gloria Molina will have no choice but to seek his resignation. But then again, with the Republican support that he has, like John Gotti, he'll sidestep this innuendo and slip through the cracks of justice no better than a criminal caught on their last strike for stealing pizza. I mean, come on, man. Can you see the irony? Seeing this pig sweat behind the very same bullets he used on so many poor people while leaving the affluent alone. Talk about segregated justice for all. To call for an investigation is futile to the cliquish bullshit that LA is known for. Now I ask, is there a gang problem here along with the thin blue line of perceived justice, or will the public ultimately demand the head of the dragon so that the body will fall? This is your come to Jesus moment. Bubba Baca, your ass into a sling, because now you have to pay the piper as the greatest asshole of them all. To wrap up, if you missed it, then play it again till you get it. You can say moving forward like a biatch, but know that I'm ahead of your bullshit. This has been your radio show, Bust That Ass Radio, 83.17 FMX, and of course the X stands for you never saw me where I was going. Okay, you didn't see me coming, but you never saw where I've been, all up in your ass. Steady shellacking the rum pum pum harder than ever, booty bubbles and dirty condoms. Music provided by Omega 7 Records, the Mothership Connection, aka Destruct and the Underground Music King. That's right, cash your ass, and I'll see you in the street, bitches! Ha ha!